Edge of Darkness was kind of marking, and Black Smoke Rising were both songs that were kind of marking a turning point in the band's evolution.
Written actually in the studio when we were working on the other songs for the EP, which it actually turned into the title track, which is pretty interesting. Black Smoke really took over the whole project.
Both of those are kind of a little deeper and more philosophical themes, both very human themes. You know, Edge of Darkness is kind of about war. And, you know, and then you've got the rock and roll song, Edge of Darkness, that, you know, doesn't particularly care for any of the rules. And then says, Brothers, we stand for the peace of the land. You know, when you hear that lyric, it certainly changes your perspective, my perspective, when I'm on stage. Now, you know, and I'm standing next to my other two brothers and Danny. And so, you know, it's like, as brothers, we stand for the peace of the land. And it feels like, you know, it feels like we're doing, you know, we're doing this, you know, this for all the right reasons, I guess. And there's a lot of that, you know, feeling of love, peace, and unity when that's said, you know. And Black Smoke Rising is kind of about lessons of history, you know, that Aldous Huxley thing that men, the greatest lesson of history is that men don't always learn from the lessons of history. The archetypes, you know, the towers and the bloodshed and the innocent victims and things like that that continue to happen throughout. Tales like, you know, the fall of the Roman Empire, all dating that far back.
You know, I think when Jake started playing those chords together, and, you know, I was on piano and Josh was singing, and, you know, I think Daniel was on guitar too. We felt like we had something very heavy on our shoulders, you know, as soon as we got that. So we started working on it immediately. Listening to that is kind of like listening to the bomb siren go off. You know, it's kind of a warning. It's kind of an archetypal, you know, kind of war of unevenness between people.
I think that that a lot of, you know, the variant material on the album and choosing to cover, like, you know, Change Is Gonna Come by Sam Cooke and Meet on the Ledge by, you know, Fairport Convention. It was sort of, you know, our approach at sort of showing versatility, you know, sort of a variety of our influences and sort of, you know, more showcasing folk influence with Meet on the Ledge and soul influences with, you know, Change Is Gonna Come. And we had to do Change Is Gonna Come because for me that was a great message. It's a song about oppression, you know. It was a very difficult song to record emotionally because it's a very, heavy song, you know, something I feel very passionate about. Makes me feel like I'm alive. She's an outsider. I think Flower Power, for me, is a song about, that really captures that peace, love, and unity as a theme. And it was kind of inspired by the Haight-Ashbury sort of scene in San Francisco. It's the initial thing, you know? I think it sounds very Greta Van Fleet to me, you know? Everyone knows that just
talking on the streets. It was really inspired by, you know, the things people say about other people, you know, without having any grounding foundation.
It was, I think, Talk on the Street is a real fun song. It's a very stylized, sort of bluesy rock and roll, you know, get your kicks off kind of song, you know.
You know, that sort of fun, you know, the fun song that's easy to get up to and move to is Talk on the Street. So, you know, it was sort of trying to, you know, have divergent elements of the newest four songs.
I think that was our coming into understanding what, you know, being well known is more like. I never thought in a million years would go to the number one spot on rock radio. Which was actually, it was crazy for all of us. We're like, what? Like, you know, first, you know, we released it on the very first. It was actually our very first entrance into the world of music, which is, you know, maybe why it's so interesting. it was the first thing out of the gates. And I feel like it's a very simple song. It's a very rudimentary song, but there's so much expression in it, and it's very, very rock and roll. You know, I mean, it goes to show the rudimentary behavior of, you know, how we were when we wrote Highway Tune. Very simple rock tune, you know, two parts of the whole thing, verse, chorus, and then moving into Black Smoke. So I think it kind of shows a direction, you know, the direction that we're going. It's interesting, you know, when we write songs, I find that often when we tap into these creative wells, the songs come in pairs. Like Highway Tune and Safari Song was a pair, and Talk on the Street and Edge of Darkness was a pair, and the Flower Power and one that we haven't released yet, You're the One, that, you know, it always comes in pairs. It's really strange, but you know, it's because we don't really have this way that we write songs. It's just, you know, it comes from where it comes from. We've written songs from like little 5-note melodies. We've written songs from just a chord progression. A lot of songs from riffs, you know. So it's, you know, it comes from everywhere. So